Madam President, this new year represents an opportunity for us to refocus and plan for our year ahead. Unfortunately, of course, for millions of Americans, their focus will be on just trying to stay afloat over the next year while they search for work. All of us here know there is no more important issue for middle-class families across America right now than jobs and the economy. This is what they want their elected officials to be focused on, and it is exactly what I think we ought to be working on here every day. Now, by reaching a bipartisan agreement last month, we did a number of things to work towards that goal. First of all, and importantly, we showed the American people that members of Congress can work together, that we can listen to each other, and that we can get into a room and, frankly, without trying to hurt each other politically. But secondly, by breaking through that partisanship, we finally ended that seemingly never-ending cycle of lurching from crisis to crisis. And third, we showed compromise isn't a dirty word, and that there is a big coalition that is ready to make some sacrifices politically to get things done. And finally, and importantly, for our efforts to continue to grow our economy, we gave American families and businesses the certainty that they need to grow. But of course, there is much more to do. And as much as we are heartened by the headlines that predict a strong economy this year, we understand just how fragile our recovery still is, with millions of Americans still out of work. Madam President, now is the time to redouble our efforts, not shrink from the challenges that we face. Because the truth is that all the economic predictions in the world mean nothing if we don't continue to support policies that help our middle class. And that work absolutely starts with extending unemployment benefits for the millions of Americans who've been losing their benefits since December 28th. Because unemployment assistance goes right back into the economies of communities, large and small, and nonpartisan economists have found it is one of the most effective ways to build a recovery that lasts. Those same economists have said that failure to continue these benefits will cost us over 200,000 jobs, and renewing these benefits is simply the right thing to do at a time when millions of American families continue to teeter on the brink in states where unemployment remains stubbornly high. Madam President, I've come to the Senate floor today with the hopes that we can continue with the bipartisan momentum that we saw with today's cloture vote and that we've seen over the last few weeks, and take a final vote to provide a lifeline for millions of Americans. This should be an easy issue. It would be simply wrong to cut this support off while our economy continues to struggle and so many workers are really having difficulty finding work. Right now, in fact, there are 3 unemployed workers for every single job opening. If every opening was filled tomorrow, we would still have more than 7 million American workers across the country without a job to even apply for. And more than 1/3 of all unemployed workers have been out of a job for 6 months or longer, above historic averages and higher than in past recoveries. So millions of Americans are unemployed today, not because they don't want to work, not because they don't have valuable skills, but simply because they found themselves in an economy that isn't creating jobs as quickly as we need to. These unemployed workers are desperate to get back on the job, and unemployment benefits made all the difference for them and their families while they scoured the want ads, pounded the pavement, and sent out resume after resume. In fact, I have received story after story from workers and families across my home state of Washington about what unemployment benefits have meant to them and what losing them would mean for their future. These men and women can't afford to have the rug pulled out from underneath them and are now struggling with each day that passes. One of these stories came from a woman named Carol who lives in Puyallup in my home state. She's a nurse. She was laid off from her job. She decided that in order to make ends meet, she'd start her own legal nurse consulting business. And so she enrolled in classes to help her hone her entrepreneurial skills. While taking those classes, Carol relied on her unemployment benefit to get by. Then, not only were her benefits slashed significantly due to sequestration, Carol just found out she's one of the 25,000 people in Washington State whose benefits were completely cut off December 28th. As a leader in the classroom, Carol has spoken to many other soon-to-be business owners who are suffering. In the face of unexpected job loss, they now feel like they're being punished for deciding to chart a new course in their lives. They're creating work for themselves and potentially others, but now have to decide if they can continue following that dream without the critical support that unemployment benefits provide them. Carol's not alone. I heard from a woman who was laid off from her job at a plant in Keyport, Washington, early last year, and she told me, and I quote, "Living in Kitsap County, we are geographically isolated, and finding work with so many qualified applicants right now is much more difficult. This year, I have applied for over 200 jobs, and in spite of a stellar resume, I've only gotten 4 phone interviews. I've lowered my standards throughout the year and applied for jobs far below my pay grade to no avail. My husband and I have had to claim bankruptcy, and I truly worry about losing my home and displacing my children," end quote. Madam President, that's what people are facing today. And finally, there's Tracy, a woman from Everett. She's a former executive assistant with 20 years of experience. After taking time off from work to care for her dying mother and a daughter who was suffering from bipolar disorder and drug addiction, Tracy found herself without a job. And shortly after her mother passed, Tracy fell ill, making it difficult for her to look for work. While Tracy was receiving unemployment benefits, they were barely enough to cover the care her daughter required. Tracy told me that she now can't afford food and has lost over 50 pounds. She even asked that I send her a video of the speech I'm making right here, because she won't be able to tune in today because she had to get rid of her television in the process of finding savings. Like so many others, Tracy is searching high and low for that one break, and she told me, and I quote, "I just need time for someone to give me a chance," end quote. Madam President, for Tracy, unemployment benefits are not the solution. A job is what she wants, but they provide her with some critical support while she takes care of her family and tries to find that work. Those are just a few of the stories I've heard, but there are a lot like them. Millions of people across America, including an additional 38,000 in my state, stand to lose the benefits they count on if Congress doesn't act soon. These workers are not looking for a handout. They don't want to be a burden, but they need support while they work to get back on their feet and back on the job. So, Madam President, in this struggling economy, renewing these benefits is truly crucial. The nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office has said renewing unemployment benefits is one of the most effective policy tools we have to boost the economy and get money in the pockets of consumers. So I'm really hopeful that the Senate will act quickly without political games, because failure to do so wouldn't just be devastating for the families who count on this, it would also hurt many small businesses and communities to have the billions of dollars pulled away from consumers who spend it every month on food and rent and clothing. Last month's budget deal provided us with a glimmer of bipartisan hope coming into this new year. However, we have to continue working together to focus on improving the economy for middle-class Americans. We cannot afford to allow this lifeline to be cut off. The stories that I just shared today, like so many others, are heartbreaking. But they also show the fierce determination that so many who are out of work exhibit in the struggle to get back on their feet. They are stories of applying for work far below their own qualifications, of going back to school to earn the skills needed to change careers, or waking up every day to scour for jobs in their communities that all too often lack opportunity. And I believe it's Congress that needs to match their determination and grit. We took an important first step today, and I know that unemployed workers that I've heard from are watching. Today's vote is a glimmer of hope for them. We can't let it fade. We need to move this and pass this extension quickly, and the House needs to follow suit. Thank you, Madam President. I yield the floor, and I suggest the absence of a quorum.